Thank you, Warden. There are three items to report. One, County Council deliberated and approved its County Council in-camera meetings or minutes of its April 4th meeting. Secondly, it approved its in-camera minutes of its committee's AM and PM April 18th meeting. And thirdly, it adopted the following resolution in regards to the Mandaman Branch Library, and that is, one, that Lambton County Council approve the recommendation put forward by the Council of the Township of Plimpton, Wyoming, to arrange for the permanent closure of the Mandaman Library Branch, and secondly, that the 12 hours of operation per week formerly assigned to the Mandaman Branch be reallocated to the Wyoming and Kamlaki branches to ensure service levels are maintained for residents of the municipality. That's it.
Thank you. I would call on a motion to allow the delegation. We have one delegation this morning regarding a robotics program at North Lambton Lodge. So Councillor Broad and Councillor Arnold, all in favor of that, to allow them within the rail. So I would welcome the robotics group to come forward and make your presentation. I understand there's a short and then there's a demonstration that we're going to have this morning, so that's wonderful. So
good morning. My name is Joanne Mead. I work at North Lambton Lodge and Forest in the Rec and Leisure Department. And I brought along Larry Reed. He is the president of our resident council. And he has attended this program since it began about 2 years ago. Year and a half.
I'm Tanya McKinley, and I teach at Kenwood, and I am a part of the robotics program.
My name is Janet Vanaz, and I'm also a teacher at Kenwood. We applied for the funding for this program from the North Lambton Community Foundation and the Canada 150 Foundation to purchase a variety of technology, and we were fortunate to receive enough grant money to purchase 14 iPads, 12 Chromebooks, Ozobots, Osmo, Little Bits, Spheros, Dash and Dot, and some apps to put on the iPads. In order to receive the Canada 150 funds, we had to create a project that would reach a wide variety of people in our community. We decided to do a digital time capsule where students from Kenwood interviewed and documented the responses from the residents at North Lambton Lodge. The robotics program has been an extension of that project with lots of interaction between the generations and lots of teaching of technology. The robotics program started in February 2017 and has continued on this year with plans to continue on into the future. So we've brought some student representatives from each class that goes over to the North Lambton Lodge, and they're going to quickly introduce themselves, and then we have just a couple little activities that we would like to share with you.
Interact with people is very important. So we do this fun little activity that the kids are going to do now amongst themselves.
Thank you.
we're done that song, the kids feel really comfortable and the residents feel really, really comfortable with each other, and then we get into the program, what we're going to do for that day. Each day we do something different, each class. Once a week a new class goes over and teaches a different piece of technology or does something different with the technology. So right now, my younger friends are going to start to work with the technology, and our older friends are going to explain what we've brought today. So go ahead, guys. You can start your drawing.
Also, bots are little robots that respond to coded commands.
Coding is the act of giving specific commands through words and or colors.
When we change the color of the path, the also bots will perform different functions.
For instance, when there is a red, green pattern, the robot will be a tomato.
Okay, so just like that. All right. So go ahead and put Ozobot on your... on your line.
So these. These are little Ozobots. And the they're drawing, well actually they're drawing their name, and then it will respond to whatever color they use and the codes that they draw. So if we were to do it like a little green, red, then it would spin around.
So through the robotics program, we did the digital time capsule. We created our video. We submitted it to Canada 150, and when I was pulling that together, I noticed a lot of other things that came out of this program that we weren't necessarily anticipating. So I pulled together another video, and we are going to watch that video today to show all the great things that have come out of the robotics project that we were anticipating. Okay, Brad. All right, guys.
You got a friend in me.
Councilor McDougall.
No questions for you, but good on all of you for working together to share what the little people know and certainly what all of us older folks can learn. It's great to see different generations working together, and I know from my own family experience how much my own mother, while she was alive, enjoyed the relationships of students near her old age home. So, you know what? I think it's wonderful, and I think it's really fabulous for the teachers that you've been recognized by the Canada 150 people. That's a huge accomplishment for your school and for our community, and it's a wonderful story, and thanks for bringing it to us on this nice May Day.
Computer code, and it's an introduction to us as seniors, and those of us that aren't, they can teach us.
Thank you. Absolutely. Thank you so much for sharing that with us today, bringing that to us. Fantastic to see the interaction, what the younger generation can teach us, most of the generation sitting around this horseshoe, and that we need the young folks to help us through everything that we do. So kudos to everyone that's part of the program, and thank you for sharing it. We move along. Minutes from the open session of April the 4th. Moved by Councillor Broad, second by Councillor McDougall. Any questions regarding those minutes? Seeing none, all in favor? That's carried. Thank you. Correspondence. We have three pieces of correspondence. How does council want to deal with those? Moved by Councillor McCharles to receive and file. Seconded by Councillor Cook. Any questions on any of that correspondence? All in favor? That's carried. We have item number 10 is board, Sarnia Lambton Economic Partnership minutes from March 27th. Motion to receive. Councillor Gillis, seconded by Councillor McDougall. Any questions regarding those minutes? All in favor? That's carried. Thank you. Committee minutes. Committee AM minutes. I would ask that Chair Arnold present these minutes.
Thank you, Warden Weber. I present the committee minutes of April the 18th AM for Council's perusal.
Thank you. Infrastructure and development, item one, correspondence. Item number two, information reports. Item three, regarding energy from waste, looking at our agreements. Item number four is correspondence. Item number five, information reports. Cultural services. Item number six, library hours policy review. Other business, we'll note the Heritage Museum opening on May 12th. And committee meetings held there on May 16th. In camera, item number seven. Number eight, we're dealt with in camera. Number nine is to open the meeting. And 10 is adjournment. Councillor Arnold.
Thank you, Warden Weber. I move this day's minutes.
Seconded by Councillor Case. Seeing no questions, all in favor? That is carried. Thank you. Committee PM minutes. Chair Hand is not here. I call on Councillor Gilliland.
Thank you, Warden Weber. We met on April the 18th in the PM. I submit these minutes for your consideration and hopefully your approval. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Long-term care division, item one's correspondence. Item two, clarifying Bill 160. Item number three, correspondence. Number four, information reports. Corporate Services Division, item five is correspondence. Finance, Facilities, and Court Services, item six, regarding federal gas tax correspondence. Item seven, information reports. Social Services Division, eight, correspondence again. Item nine, information reports for receiving. Item number 10, affordable rental housing proposal. Councillor Gillis.
Thank you, Warden Weber, members of County Council. I would like to isolate that particular motion, if I may, and call on Mrs. Rochon to explain the flow-through money and exactly how much that is going to be added to what we have already budgeted for.
Through you, Warden. Yes, so we have $264,910 in additional IAH money to invest. So that would be the allocation of those funds. Under the Ontario Works budget, we also have an additional $105,000, and that relates to the Ontario Works portion where we assist participants who are volunteering in the project.
Follow up.
So the total number is 361.
349,910 plus 20,000 in program enhancements, so 369. Yep.
Thank you. Any other questions regarding item 10? Item 11 was the motion to adjourn. Councillor Gilliland.
Thank you. I move this day's minutes for your approval. Thanks.
Seconded by Councillor Knapper. Any further discussion? All in favor of that? That is carried. We have no items tabled from a previous meeting. No notice of the motion. Other business? Councillor Cook.
As a serving member of the Arcona Lions Club, it'd be great to announce at this time that the Lions Club, through our medical board, has secured the services of two new doctors for the village of Arcona, and great for Lambton Shores to have new doctors coming in. The doctors set up their practice about a month ago now. They've been operating and taking on new patients, and it was a two-year struggle. We went without 2 years without any doctors in Arcona, but through the work of the three-man committee, the medical committee from the Lions Club, they did all the work themselves, the research, secure and entice those doctors to come to our area. So it's nice to see that we can attract some doctors to our area.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks for sharing that. Any other new business or comments? Seeing none, notice of bylaws.
Thank you. It's moved by Councillor Bushy and seconded by Councillor Bradley that bylaw 18 of 2018, as circulated, be taken as read first and second time.
All in favor of that, of the bylaws? That's all opposed. It's carried.
It's moved by Councillor Bradley and seconded by Councillor Bushy that bylaw 18 of 2018, as circulated, be taken as read a third time and finally passed.
All in favor of that? That's carried. Thank you. Motion to adjourn at 9:56. Councillor Gillison, Councillor McDougall. All in favor of that? That is carried. Thank you.